हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अ न्यू चैप्टर इन केमिस्ट्री, दैट इज़ द केमिकल बॉन्डिंग. सी दिस केमिकल बॉन्डिंग चैप्टर यू हैव कंप्लीटेड लास्ट ईयर ऑल्सो विथ अनदर चैप्टर नेम कॉल्ड एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर एंड केमिकल बॉन्डिंग. तो लास्ट ईयर यू हैव बेसिकली स्टडीड थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ डिफरेंट केमिकल बॉन्डिंग्स यू हैव स्टडीड लास्ट ईयर. सी विच वर दे? That is the electrovalent or the ionic bond, okay, covalent bond, which you have studied last year, this two both. This year you are going to study this bond also, coordinative bond, okay, coordinative bond. So basically three types of different bonds we are going to study this year. So before starting off the bond directly, let's come to the define of a chemical bonding. So what do you mean by chemical bonding? So it is force of attraction between any two atoms in a molecule to maintain stability. So it is a force of attraction between two atoms in a molecule to maintain the stability. Okay, the word stability means what? See, we have already studied up this basic chemistry in the lower class also. How we come to know okay, whether that atom is stable or not? Because stability follows of the two principle. One is duplet and the other one is octet. The word duplet means two and word octet means eight. Okay, the word duplet means two and octet means eight. So basically this basic terminology you know. Okay, stability means what? Duplet and octet. Okay, so how we check whether the atoms are stable or not? We check whether the atoms are stable or not with the help of the noble gases like helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Okay, see the two electrons, these two electrons are present in the valence shell. What do you mean by the term valence shell? Valence shell means the outermost shell. There are two electrons in the outermost shell. So right now I am writing up the electronic configuration of this. So see, I am not going to write the electronic configuration. I will make you explain like this only. Okay, only the outermost shell. Okay, valence shell means the outermost shell. Okay, so we have studied about this. Okay, this is a helium diagram, okay, but this part is not there this year. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, this is neon. So the electrons which are present in the outermost shell, see here there are two shells, one shell and the second one in which I have drawn the electrons. So on, if you notice, only helium is the only noble gas which follows the duplet. The rest, all of them have 8 electrons in their valence shell. With the help of this valence shell only, we come to know okay, whether the atoms are stable or not. Suppose, let's take an example to make ourselves understand. This is in sodium atom. Okay, its electronic configuration is 281. The atomic number is 11 and the electronic configuration is 281. Okay, so I have to identify okay, whether this sodium is stable or not. So how I am going to analyze? I am going to look into the last shell. How many electrons are present? It is one electron which is present. Okay, the one electron which is present in the outermost shell. So what I am going to do now? So I have to follow the rule of octet. Okay, since it is not following the rule of octet, so this sodium atom will lose one electron from the outermost shell and it is going to become Na+. Now this is in sodium ion, and this was in sodium atom. So this becomes 2.8. Now what is the difference between a sodium atom and ion? See, sodium atom means what? Which does not carries up a charge at the top. And ion means what? Which carries up a charge at the top. And if you look, so it has 8 electrons in its outermost shell, which is following the rule of a octet. So we say okay, this is a stable ion. Okay, this is a stable element. So as we have said, we are going to study 3 different types of bonding. Okay, electrovalent, covalent and coordinating. So first we are going to start with the electrovalent bond. But before, electrovalent has one more name, that is the ionic bond. Why it has name ionic bond? Because it is going to form ion. And what are ions? Which carries a charge. I have shown out here. So first, in an easier term, who follows this electrovalent and ionic first? It is formed between metals plus non-metals. Second, in which transfer of electrons is possible. Transfers of electron is possible. Okay. And the third, who can attain the inert configuration, or you can call it the stability also, inert gas configuration first. So electrovalent is formed between a metal and a non-metal, in which we have to transfer the electrons. Okay, so since we transfer the electron, it can maintain up the inert gas configuration. See, I have maintained this inert gas configuration. Okay, so why we took metal and non-metal? Because see, the thing is, this is a sodium atom which can lose electron and it can form Na+. So this one is called cation. Then the next one, this is a chlorine who will gain electron and it will form a negative ion, which is called anion. Okay, this is the positive ion is called cations, and negative ions are called anions. So this is PC means what? Positive cation, negative anion. Positive cation, negative anion. Na is plus and Cl is minus. So basically, who forms a positive charge? Metals. Who forms a negative one? They are formed by the non-metals. Okay. Why the electrovalents are formed between the cations and anions only? Because they are both oppositely charged particles. Okay, they are both oppositely charged particles, and they can maintain up the strong electrostatic force of attraction. What do you mean by electrostatic force of attraction? Suppose this is sodium and these are the chlorines. Okay, if I am going to make NaCl, so it should be hold very strongly like this. Okay, this is called the strong electrostatic force of attraction. Why it is called electro? Because in this, transfer of electron is going to happen. Agar sodium ek electron lose karega, to wo ek electron gain kon karega? Chlorine. Okay, ions are always stable in nature. Ion, ions are always stable in nature. So what they will do, if it is going to lose electron, it will accept and they will form a strong bond between them. Now, we have to go through the conditions for electrovalent. Electrovalent bonds. First, it should have a low IP. IP means what? Ionization potential. Okay. Ionization potential. What do you mean by ionization potential? Ionization potential means means it is an energy in which if an atom loses the electrons easily, okay, if the atoms who loses the electrons easily, they would have a low IP. If the atom who would release the electrons very slowly, they would have a high IP. Example, we know the metal reactivity series. KNA, CA, MG, AL, okay, as on. So suppose this is a metal reactivity series. All out of these metals, who is highly reactive in nature? Potassium. Out of this, okay. And who is least reactive? This. Why this is highly reactive in nature? Because it can lose electrons fast. It can lose electrons fast and it can easily form cation. But when it comes to the aluminium, it can also lose the electrons and it can also form the cation. But the problem is that K can easily lose electrons. Whereas in the case of the aluminium, it won't lose the electrons that fast. According to the metal reactivity series. Isliye to potassium sabse zyada reactive hai. Okay? Because it can easily lose up the electrons. And aluminium can lose the electron but not that fast than K. So why it can lose electrons easily? Because it has the low IP. Why it takes a lot of time? Because it has the high IP. So IP ka matlab hota hai ionization potential, which means you can lose the electrons fast. So this was all about the metals part, okay? The first condition. The second condition would lead to high electro affinity. The word affinity means love. Okay, this all terms IP, electro affinity have been already covered in your periodic table chapter. High electro affinity. Okay. So if you have the high electro affinity, you can form. See, if you have a high electron love, means who is going to accept the electrons? Definitely this come for the non-metals part. Okay, because they only love the electron. If this is a chlorine, it would readily accept this electron. It will form anion. As they form cations, they will readily form anion. Okay. So high electro affinity means what? Who can readily accept up the electron and form the anion. This atom can readily accept the electron very fast and can form anion easily. And the third and the last one, it should have a large or a high electronegativity difference. Sodium is positively charged, chlorine is negatively charged. Okay, here it has low IP and it has high electro affinity. So when this electron would be loose, so definitely there would be a transfer of electrons toward this chlorine and hence we can form up a bond called NaCl. So the electronegativity difference should be quite large. Okay, there should be quite large. which is the most ionic bond? Now it would be a quite a objective based question. That is cesium fluoride. Okay, cesium fluoride. Is the most ionic bond. Why it is most ionic bond? Because cesium has the lowest IP. Lowest means what? सबसे कम इसके पास है. And it has the highest electron affinity. Highest. Lowest IP and highest EO. So that is why it can easily form of this bond. Now, usually ionic compounds are stable in nature. Why it is so? Why ionic compounds are stable? Because there is a strong electrostatic force of attraction between the two opposing charges. So that is why it makes them stable. See, if Na would give its one electron to chlorine, so why it is giving its one electron? Because it has to form this Na plus. And why this chlorine is accepting? Because it want to complete up its octet. Since they are the oppositively charged, okay, since they are the opposite charge, their electrostatic force of attraction is very high. Their electrostatic force of attraction is high. As their electrostatic force of attraction is high, they can readily form up the stability. Okay, what do you mean by word stable? Who follows up the duplet and octet. Some examples. Any of the compound, okay, you can write any of the compound, NaCl, MgCl2, calcium oxide, okay, KBr, etc. Many examples are there. Now first I'm going to draw some structures for you. Okay, suppose first structure is NaCl. The first what we are going to do? First we are going to write before combination. Okay, this is Na. Okay, so Na, the electronic configuration is 281 and the chlorine is 287. In exams they will give you atomic number, okay, atomic number will be provided, like 17 diya hai to aapko sirf electronic configuration likhna hai, sir 11 diya hai to aapko ye likhna hai. But the only thing you should remember, you should write the last one, okay, that is the valence shell electrons, okay. One chlorine has 7. So I will represent it by dot and one by cross. Why? This cross indicates this is the electron which is present in the outermost shell of the sodium. And this 7 dots indicate these are the electrons which is present in the outermost shell of the chlorine. Okay. In the before combination, this is considered to be the sodium atom. This is considered to be the chlorine atom. Okay. This is considered as the sodium atom and this is considered as the chlorine atom. This is the before combination. Okay, what exactly happens after that? See, when the reaction is going to happen, okay, so I have to show that this electron is going to get transferred. So while drawing up the after combination, okay, when we are going to draw the after combination, so it will lose one electron and it will acquire a plus charge. And this chlorine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this cross will grow out here. And I am going to write because as this chlorine is accepting the electron, this would be negative one. Okay, in before combination there was a plus sign in between. Why there was a plus sign? Because they both were in the state of the atom, and now the plus sign will go when we are going to write the after combination. We have to write this all words. Now a charge is developed. So now it is not an atom, now it is in sodium ion. Now this chlorine becomes chloride then. Aye. And in the last you have to write NaCl. Okay, or simply, and you have to write the name simply. That is the sodium. Okay, very easy. Then MgCl2 also the same. MgCl2. The atomic number is 12, so the 282 means the last number is important. Chlorine is 287. Now this is magnesium. Before that you have to write this is before combination. Okay, before combination it is 2 electron. Let's represent this by cross. Plus chlorine 7, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So in order to create up the difference, one I will represent by cross and the other one by dots. This is nothing but the magnesium atom, this is nothing but the chlorine atom. In the after combination, and you have to show that this electrons are going to get move out here. Now a logic comes. In order to complete up its octet, it need only one electrons, but the magnesium has two electrons. See, magnesium ke paas do electrons hai, and chlorine has only need one electrons. So iske paas ek extra bachega. मतलब मैग्नीशियम वोंट बी एबल टू कंप्लीट अप इट्स ऑक्टेट. ओके, सो व्हाट इट इज गोइंग टू डू, इट इज गोइंग टू रिएक्ट विथ वन मोर क्लोरीन लाइक दिस. ओके, वन मोर क्लोरीन इज गोइंग टू गेट प्लेस आउट हियर. सो सिंस द प्लेस इज नॉट देयर, यू हैव टू ड्रॉ वन मोर क्लोरीन लाइक हियर. ओके, एंड यू हैव टू शो देम कि द इलेक्ट्रॉन गॉट ट्रांसफर लाइक दिस. Suppose this is a chlorine. This is a chlorine atom. Now after combination. After combination. This is magnesium. Okay. It has lost these two electrons. Now it becomes 2 plus. But at the same period of time, how many chloride ions are there? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 1 I am going to represent cross. And in the front, I am going to write 2 and minus. Why have 2 written out here? Because I have to show that there were the 2 chloride ions. Okay, there are the formation of the 2 chloride ions. And in the last, you can write MgCl. Okay, this is the after combination. You just have to write the name. Okay, this was a magnesium ion. This was the chloride ion. And the whole name is magnesium chloride. Now there is an homework for you. You have to draw the calcium oxide. I will write the atomic number of calcium as 20 and oxygen as 8. Now you have to make this. Okay, this is the part of the homework. सी रिमेंबर वाई आई हैव मेड दिस वन मोर क्लोरीन, बिकॉज इसके पास दो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स थे बट इसको एक ही चाहिए था, तो वन मोर क्लोरीन. दिस इज आई विल मेक इट लिटिल डार्क फॉर यू. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 हियर ऑल्सो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 एंड वन क्रॉस विल ग्रो आउट हियर, वन क्रॉस विल ग्रो आउट हियर. ओके, ये 2 मल्टीप्लाई हो रहा है, मतलब क्या, ये 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स को रिप्रेजेंट करेगा. ओके, सो दिस वॉज द पार्ट 1 ऑफ द केमिकल बॉन्डिंग चैप्टर. इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द इलेक्ट्रोवैलेंट बॉन्ड और द आयोनिक बॉन्ड. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स.